Ryan, how do you process what's happened in the last few days, and just talk us through how it all came about from your perspective?
Yeah, relatively easy from my point of view. Naturally, I feel comfortable, so it's just part of being involved in football, I guess. Have to be ready, and I am ready. I don't doubt that. So it's just business. We've got a really, really big game on Thursday. We've got another one Sunday. So the focus on my behalf and the group is to fully prepare for that.
You've spoken a lot in the past about positivity and that kind of giving off those positive vibes. What's your top priority this week, given how negative it actually has been around the place of late?
A reaction. Absolutely a reaction. Obviously, Sunday was disappointing for us, and I would hope and expect that there is a reaction from not only the players, but from everyone in this building and everyone involved in the club as well.
What did you make of that gesture for the players to reimburse the travelling fans at Newcastle?
Yeah, I'm pleased because our fans are important to us. We value them, we need them, and understand that relationships probably wavered a little bit recently, but listen, there's no doubt that we need them, we want them on board, and hopefully Thursday they can feel us.
You've been in this position before, of course. How have you evolved in the time since that first spell?
Yeah, I mean, from a personal point of view, probably just confirmation that I'm absolutely ready for this sort of situation. We handled it well 2 years ago. Obviously, a lot of things have happened in the last 2 years, but ultimately, from my point of view, I feel fine. I feel ready in this situation.
Antonio Conte said earlier in the season that he sensed the players didn't want to play under stress, under pressure to achieve what he wanted them to achieve. Have you seen that in this squad of players?
No, I'm not going to get drawn into any comments in the past. My focus is on Thursday, it's Sunday, and we've got six games towards the end of the season to try and have a positive little run. But one thing I will say is that I believe in this group, and I believe in this football club as well.
Yeah. Is it? Are they lacking a little bit of confidence? Is it simple as that, or can it be explained as simple as that?
No, I've been involved in football long enough to know that things can turn around very quickly. A result can change a lot. So, like I say, I believe in the group. I believe in what I will want to do and we will want to do. So hopefully we can transmit that to the pitch.
Daniel Levy said recently that he thinks Harry Kane can win a trophy at this football club, and that a statue could be built of him outside the stadium. Number one, I'm guessing you will agree that he deserves a statue outside the stadium, but also, can you play any part in your role of knowing him so well to help him and convince him to extend that contract and stay on at this club?
No, for me personally, honestly, it's not about an individual. In this moment, it's about a group of players, the staff that are involved, and the club as a whole. The season's not over yet. We have six important games as well. So the focus isn't on any individual, it's on the group, and that's not going to change.
Are you convinced you can block that out? Because I guess with someone like Harry Kane comes down to that final year of his contract and all of that talk is ongoing, can that be a distraction in that run-in of games?
No, there's always talk. When you play for a club like this and you're involved in a club like this, there's going to be talk. But most importantly, we need to be close in the changing room, in this training centre, and if we're compacting here, then that'll transfer onto the pitch, and the speculation is speculation, ultimately. That's not going to affect us in the changing room.
Just a final one. I know that the backdrop to a lot of this at the moment, the Tottenham fans have been recently singing the name of someone who's very popular here, Mauricio Pochettino, and it now looks like he could be the next Chelsea manager. Is that going to take some processing, some time to get used to from a Tottenham perspective, obviously somebody who knows him so well?
Not from my point of view, no. Like I say, the focus is on inside here. We're not gonna listen and look on the outside noise, because there's going to be outside noise, but we have to focus on our jobs, and our jobs is to get results on the football pitch, and my feeling is that comes from the training ground and the training pitch as well. So that's our only focus right now.
Thanks, Ryan. Good luck.
Hi, Ryan. Morning. You know this club inside out as a player and as a coach. Is that the most challenging times you ever experienced here at Spurs?
Honestly, I'm not sure. I'm not sure. Obviously, from my point of view, I'm not thinking about all the challenges and the negatives. I feel like we can make a positive impact. We've got a great game on Thursday to try and react and get back to winning ways as soon as possible. So the feeling and the thought isn't on the whole situation. It's about how we're going to influence the players and get some positivity back, yeah.
What type of reaction and mindset do you expect from the players tomorrow night?
Yeah, a reaction, because as a professional, when you have a result like we did, you want a reaction. I expect one. Absolutely, I think that takes care of itself as a professional, and you see with the gesture that the players done for the fans as well. We were hurting, but ultimately that was a couple of days ago now, and our focus is on Thursday, and we're going to approach that with full belief that we can get a positive result.
At home against a difficult opposition, what role will the fans and their support will have tomorrow?
Yeah, obviously massive. It's our home, and they need to be with us, but at the same time, we need to get them with us as well. So that's our job as a group, to make sure that we give them something to cheer about.
What did you make of Man United's performance against Brighton on Sunday? What do you expect from them tomorrow?
Yeah, two good teams. Obviously, they've got their strengths. They've had a relatively good season. They've won a trophy, which is important for any big club. So we understand it's gonna be a difficult match, but ultimately we're at home and we have full belief that we can get a positive result.
It's only 6 points in the table, but what do you think is the real difference, the real gap at the moment between Spurs and Man United?
No, I'm not thinking about that. We've got a game on Thursday, and the only focus is on getting a result Thursday. This whole bigger picture, that's irrelevant to me. We've got a game to prepare for, and we're going to do that to the best that we can.
Hi, Ryan.
You all right?
Yeah, good, are you surprised that 2 years after you did this first time round, we're back in this situation again?
Nothing surprises me in football, honestly. I've been in this game long enough. I've been coaching for the best part of 6 years now. So these things happen in football. You just have to be ready. You have to be prepared to deal with it. And like I said a minute ago, I'm absolutely ready to deal with this situation.
Ready for this situation? What about ready for doing it full time? I mean, is this an opportunity for you again this time to say, right, I'm acting head coach now, but I want the job full time. I can fix the problems here full time.
Yeah, honestly, for me, I feel ready. I know I'm ready. If that situation happens, it obviously means that we've done a good job. But that's fast forward in 4 or 5 weeks' time. Like I say, the immediate thought is the game on Thursday, and also we have a game on Sunday. So we've got a big week, and we've also got a big 5 weeks before anyone in here even starts to think about that sort of situation.
As someone who loves the club, how much have you been hurt by the last few days and people taking the mickey out of Spurs in the situation they're now in?
I'm hurt when we lose, like our players and like our fans as well. I don't listen to other people because my opinion and our feeling inside is the most important thing. And we know that, yeah, in recent weeks or months, I guess, it hasn't sort of been good enough or what we would expect the level to be. But like I said, football can change very quickly. And we hope that we can put a performance in on Thursday to get that.
You've got a lot of experience with you here as well. I know Matt Wells has come in. You've got Chris Powell, Nigel Gibbs, Paul Bracewell. You know, there's a lot of experience for you to, if you want to, lean on, isn't there?
Absolutely, yeah. And I think that's where I feel fortunate. Yeah, I've been coaching 6 years, which I think is a long time. I spent a lot of time on the grass. But probably more importantly for me, the people that I've worked with and come across have accelerated my growth as an individual, and of course there's many people that I trust and value their opinion in this training centre and also outside that I'm always in communication with.
Just a couple more. First of all, how is your, without giving away your formation and your philosophy, will it be what we've seen the rest of the season previously, or will you try and change things around a little bit?
I think from my point of view at the moment, the most important thing is to get some sort of energy, some sort of positivity back into the group, but not only the group, the fans and the club have to be realistic as well. When you have two training sessions, three training sessions before two games, it's hard to change a great deal. But I would hope and expect towards the end of the season that everyone, not only inside but outside, will see my stamp or our stamp on the group.
How often has you been
For the game on Thursday, we're still unsure. Obviously, he had a muscle problem, so we're still seeing how that's settling down. But, yeah, time will tell on that one.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Hi, Ryan. In terms of injuries, Clement Monlay, Ben Davis, are they in a position to start for this time?
And we're going to review them today. We've got training in the afternoon, so we're going to have to see them too today. Obviously, both of them have been out. Clem come off in a game recently, and Ben's been out for a period of time. So I think we'll have a better idea on that one after training today.
Tottenham fans have had a tough time a bit of late. What would be your message for the supporters going into the final six games?
Listen, I've been involved in this football club a long time, and my belief is that our fans are amazing and one of the best in the world. So we want to get them on board. We want to get them with us. And the only way to do that is to put in performances that warrant that. So we understand that and we know that. So I don't think there'll be any doubt that they'll be with us on Thursday night.
Have you seen a reaction from the players in training since you beat Newcastle?
Yeah, obviously it's only been a couple of days. We haven't been able to train a great deal, but like I touched upon, we're hurting from that sort of result. So that one for me takes care of itself in terms of hopefully getting a reaction.
All right. You mentioned there about how ready you feel. Has it been difficult the last few games, sort of being the kind of acting assistant, knowing that you're ready to do the role yourself?
No, I've always said that what this club feels best for me. In this period of my career, I will do. And we felt that was best. The club felt that was best. So I was absolutely happy to do that. Obviously, it didn't go as we had all planned. But we're in this situation now where we can focus on the next six games. And like I say, hopefully have a positive impact on the rest of the season and set us up for next season.
Obviously, the players are coming off the back of a 6-1 loss. What was your way of kind of lifting them up? I mean, did you get into them on the training ground, or was it more sort of trying to understand how that happened?
No, them sort of things, I think, stay in the changing room, stay on the training pitch. That's how I want to manage the group. That's how I want to approach it. And that type of thing stays in this training centre.
Just, obviously, last time you had six league games this time, but this time around you start, as you say, with United and Liverpool in a very short space of time. Is this an even tougher ask than it was 2 years ago?
I think it's a different situation. Obviously, we had a cup final that weekend that I took over last time. Every situation's different, but like I say, we've got a period of time now where we can prepare as much as we can to try and get a result. And obviously, when you have weeks leading into games, you can influence a little bit more. But at the moment, we understand the situation. We're realistic in what we can and can't do on the training pitch and how much we can put into them. So Thursday's, we're aware it's a big game for us.
Ryan, can I just ask you, have you been in touch with Daniel Levy? Have you spoken to him before? I mean, do you feel he's also hurting with all that's going on, having to change managers? What's the impression you have if you've spoken to him before taking up this role?
Yeah, obviously, from a club point of view, the situation we're in now is, it's not where we wanted to be or expected to be at the start of the season, but ultimately that's football. That happens sometimes, and we can't get caught up on things that have happened. We all understand that we have to finish this season well and strong and united as a group within this training ground, and that's my job ultimately to do that.